of all of us at LS Raider School of Art. Let me give you a small introduction of Mr. Jagtap. Chetan sir is an alumni of LS Raija School of Art, Bandra. He has done 1 year of fine art and after that a diploma in applied art. He started his advertising career with a job at Lintas, which is now Low Worldwide. He also became a creative director in a small span of 9 years of his career and was heading Mudra Ahmedabad as a creative head. After that, as creative head in Everest Brand Solutions, heading the team for Parle Biscuits account. He was also a creative head in Mudra for much well-known Surf Excel Henna print campaign. Till date, he has launched various brands. He has also a glorious portfolio on many TVCs and ad films, apart from brand advertising. Some of them are Vim Bar, Crack Cream, Blue Dart, Fortune Coconut Oil with Irfan Khan, Unaiko Biscuit with Amir Khan, and Hrithik Roshan for Parle Hide and Seek, and Rachna. Currently, he has his own advertising agency with the name Inner Voice Communication and Design. I would now request Chetan sir to take this session forward.
Thanks a lot, ma'am. Okay, it seems quite a bit on the face of it to hear a lot many big things about any creative person who has been in the industry for about 10 to 15 years or 20 years. But I would urge you guys not to get overwhelmed with it and not to feel that अरे बाप रे ये तो कुछ और ही है करके नथिंग लाइक दैट आई एम अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ आर्ट एंड आई एम स्टिल लर्निंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ माय ओन एक्सपीरियंस इन टर्म्स ऑफ एडवर्टाइजिंग एंड डिजाइन एंड एवरी डे इज अ वी कॉल इट लर्निंग प्रोसेस आई वुड लाइक टू हियर सम इंटरेक्शन फ्रॉम यू गाइस हूएवर वांट्स टू इंट्रोड्यूस योरसेल्फ एंड टॉक अबाउट व्हाई यू जॉइन एडवर्टाइजिंग and what is your goal ahead? Guys, let's make it interactive so that I'm not the only one who's talking out here because I don't like to make it be that way. So anyone? कुछ सामने खुद से सामने आए नहीं आओगे तो मैं नाम लेके बोलूंगा फिर हर्षा बिनवानी
Students, please speak. It is an interaction, interactive session. So I request all of you to speak and answer what sir is asking you all.
So I would have loved to have a very interactive session offline, wherein all you guys must have been attending college and we would have had a very one-on-one kind of a session. So guys, let's chat a little bit and then get into presentation because I know बहुत सारे लोग नींद में से उठे होंगे, just sign in किया होगा. Or just like trying to get out of the bed and get into this thing. So that's the reason why I was playing that music out there, so that you guys start waking up. Hello, who? Arun. Arun, are you there? अरुण शायद ऑन करके सो गया है अंकिता बड़ेकर अच्छा ये हु इज द सीआर ऑफ द क्लास
हेलो सर गुड मॉर्निंग
हाय रांची हाउ आर यू
हाय सर गुड हाउ आर यू
आई एम गुड आई
एम यस सो आई एम हिरांशी एंड The, like from school I was really fascinated with all this like the advertising side of the thing and in school and college also I was very like you know taking parts in all the fairs and the marketing and all of that departments so I really thought of choosing this for my further studies
so you are good in art primarily
Yes.
Great. And what do you where do you want to go from here on? What is your dream?
So, to be honest, really, I haven't really thought of what I'm going to do after this. But yes.
So I would urge you to start thinking about it, because what happens is that you're already in your third year right now, and if you guys don't have a vision for yourself, then it's like I don't know your opinion, where you will land up, and you'll be still figuring out. To give you
Yes, sir.
suggestion, give you my this thing. I had the privilege of going to a guru, and he introduced me to. That was when I got into Applied Art. And after that, I got a guru who was guided me into basically having a vision for myself. And that vision was that I grew up with that vision saying that my first job has to be in Mintas. And I had envisioned myself to the rank of a creative director, wherever I would be. And that was the only part I was looking at. After that, I thought about becoming an NCD, a National Creative Director, or an Executive Creative Director, and all that stuff. So Destiny gave me my whatever I had thought about, and then I started my own company. Right. So throughout college, I was dreaming about this thing that my first job has to get into. Somehow I have to get into Lindas advertising, and I did get into it. So my first job was Lindas. So guys, I would urge you guys to have a dream and start thinking about where you want to land up after this course, right? And one suggestion which I would give you is that the more and more you interact with professionals from the industry, the more clearer you will be about your thought process and where you want to land up, right? Because advertising is changing drastically from where we started on and now where digital advertising is going and this thing. The principles remain the same, but then it kind of is the way we approach advertising is changing, and hence we need to adapt ourselves. Anyone else who is there who wants to talk his heart out?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Myself, Salvi. Yeah. So I had not planned of taking an advertising field. I was planning for fine arts, but my sir told me to take this field, and I guess I'm doing really well in this now, so I'm enjoying this.
Which sir told you to get into Applied Art?
I was in Atul Fine Arts in my 12th standard. I was learning from Atul sir and Chandan sir. They both are from JJ School of Arts. So they told me to take in Sophia College, and I have done my foundation from Sophia, and now I'm here in Raicha.
And they themselves have been into Applied Art, like they are professors for Applied Art.
What?
The professors who gave you that advice, are they from Applied Art?
Yeah, the Atul sir was from Fine Arts, and the Chandan sir was from Applied Arts JJ.
Okay. So I would suggest that they have given you the right advice, but one thing I would like to urge you to do is that keep your aspirations of fine art, the fine art side of yours, on, so that you stay in touch with drawing and painting.
Yes.
That's where the entire crux of advertising starts. So Applied Art has stemmed out of fine art, and therefore it's like classical singing and Bollywood this thing. So it stems from classical singing, right? So that's how things are. Great. Anyone else? Anyone else? Computer Rahita, Chaitra Pandurangi.
Yes, sir. Hello, good morning, sir.
Hi, Chaitra. Hi.
Yes. Okay, so my name is Chaitra, and I actually didn't plan to apply arts to land in applied arts as well. I was about like doing BA, but then I realized that I'm not much of a theoretical person. So, and I always like drawing and painting. So everybody suggested to everybody in the sense, My parents, so they suggested to me to go for this.
Your parents are in design?
No. My dad is a teacher. He was a teacher. He retired last year, and he was math teacher. But he was always, he's more into this than me. He tried to get into JJ when he was my age, but he didn't get there. So then he just did BSc and everything went out there.
Oh, brilliant. Is that your dad supported him?
Yeah, he's very supportive.
Because typically, I don't know if anyone, what's the other, like, what everyone's experiences are, when they first break out this news to their parents that I want to get into art. And that's the time when the parents are like completely dumbfounded and say that he was who are the kid after the era.
Yeah, my other family members were like that only. They started saying like you should have taken science and do doctor or engineering or something. Why are you taking arts and all? But I was pretty sure and my parents were supportive, so yeah.
So one of my the first time when I broke the news to my parents, my mom was of course supportive, but my dad was not. And of course, during our times, the scene was also different. There was not many much common knowledge of what and where art or advertising is. So my dad was like, "Arey, tu rastavarti Ganpati karun paise kamun arka." Right. So that is the thing. So to translate it is that, "Arey, tu raste pe Ganpati nikal ke paisa kamayega." Okay, that is the imagery he had. Right, and there was nothing wrong in that, but that thing kind of scared me, to be very frank. And I also visualized myself, so therefore, that propelled me to basically, that generated the insecurity, and that propelled me to get into advertising and do a lot of hard work, right? So I started planning, I started having a vision for myself in terms of what I need to do to stop me from landing on a road drawing a Ganpati and people just giving me some chiller paisa out there. Right? So great. So I think you guys are ready for the presentation, right? What do you guys know about packaging and design? Have you done any assignments on packaging and design? So today's topic is about the art of packaging design. Design thinking and inspiration. It so happened that as art directors, we are always when we land up in an agency, everyone is dreaming about trying to make a television commercial or a print ad or anything to do with advertising which can be released and people can see it and say that, "Arey," and you can show it to the world that, "Look, this is my advertising, this is my ad," and all, right? For me, when I landed up, I had to do a lot of packaging before my first ad got released, right? And packaging was something which always kept me away from getting that one thing, a television commercial or a print ad or doing some brand work out there. To such an extent that I started realizing that packaging is something which an art director has to do compulsorily. And there is no other person in the advertising agency who can do packaging design, right? So art director, there's a print ad, art director karega, let's say packaging ke art director bhi karega, dusra koi nahi karega. So you can't escape it, and the agency is paying you for that, right? So that I thought that let's try and create a portfolio of packaging and packaging design, so that that itself becomes a. So that was the problem which I had at my hand. So I tried to find a solution for the same. Right. So started my this thing in terms of my journey towards trying to look at packaging differently. And I think I've done some bit. There's a long way ahead to go and achieve what many good designs or anything. But I've cracked something out. So today, what we'll do is that the first part might be a little technical, because it's very important that as art directors, you also know about what goes into the printing and the various kinds of packaging designs which are there available, and therefore that will help you to think differently for the medium, right? So with your permission, I'll just share my screen. Before we do that, you can say hi to one of my two young budding art directors who are from this. That's Mihir and that's Purvi. Purvi is from Viva School of Art, and Mihir is basically doing internship with me. Right? You can say hi. So wherever you guys get bored, now please let me know, because I can go on and on, and sometimes there are times when I lose track. Okay, you guys can see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, no? Saurabh, what did you say?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right, so basically kya hai ki you guys can see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so when I started doing packaging, I thought that typically I would like to hear from you, have you done a packaging assignment in college? Hello?
Yes, sir.
What did you guys think about it when you got the first packaging assignment out there? Can we have a quick thing? So the thing is, why I'm asking you this question is because I want to know your thought process in terms of how do you approach an assignment and how do you listen. So finally, the way the workshop will unfold is, I do the presentation. Then you can ask me questions. After that, we'll form groups. You'll be divided into 7 to 8 groups. Then, as a group, you have to select a brand. Then you have to design a packaging for that. After that, when you design the packaging, you have to share a presentation with us, with me and the faculty. And from there on, we get into also advertising ideas for the same brand. So we can cover up design thinking in terms of advertising also. So that's the way we are doing it. So you guys need to just tell me in terms of what was the first experience when you did packaging design and how did you approach it?
Researching.
So, ma'am, पॅकेजिंग ची असाइनमेंट झाली आहे ना
सर? थर्ड इयर मध्ये अजून नाही झाली आहे.
ओके, पण फर्स्ट इयर सेकंड इयर मध्ये?
सेकंड इयर मध्ये चैत्रा, तुमची सेकंड इयर मध्ये पॅकेजिंग असाइनमेंट झाली आहे का?
येस
मॅम, झाली आहे सर सेकंड इयर मध्ये.
कोणी काय बोलत का नाही? काय केलं होतं चैत्रा?
सर, टाईल आर्ट स्टुडिओ साठी पॅकेजिंग केलेली.
कशासाठी?
टाईल आर्ट स्टुडिओ. टाइल आर्ट म्हणजे टाइल साठी या
टाइल साठी केलं आहे.
हां
बाकी अजून कोणी काय काय केले होते मला फक्त सब्जेक्ट्स कळले तर थोडेसे
कॅम्पेन मध्ये केलेलं पॅकेजिंग
कशामध्ये
कॅम्पेन साठी पॅकेजिंग पण होतं त्याच्यात केलेलं.
कुठलं कॅम्पेन होतं?
मी जम्बो किंग वर केलेलं
वडापाव.
हां वडापाव.
अजून
So as Chaitra told, I love studios, so there was an option between Tile Art Studio and wallpapers studio. So then I took wallpaper studio. So the label of the wallpapers and the booklet and all of that.
But see, that is still in terms of what you say, a catalog, right? It's not packaging. Anything which, where anyone who has taken a brand, like say, an ex-deodorant or bimbar or whatever, any of the products, it's primarily what we are going to cover today is in terms of how to approach brand packaging. Backlogs and all. Anyways, so I want you guys to be interactive because that's how you would learn. See, the thing is, in online thing, what happens is that everyone is shutting off their cameras and everyone is on mute mode and just trying to see that, okay, let this thing pass. And then you have to just let it go. So at the end of the day, if you guys don't learn anything out of it, this exercise is a waste, right? And whenever professionals are coming to you, you guys have to make the best out of it by trying to be interactive so that you can clear your doubts or whatever. So fair enough. As we warm up to each other, maybe going forward, we'll you guys will be more interactive. Otherwise, I'll call the groups at my office and you can present me out there. So anyways, let's go ahead. Okay, so what I felt was the packaging, and after having constantly been subjected to packaging on Rin Supreme, Pure It and Bim Bar and all, I thought that what can I do? Because I was very thirsty in terms of trying to put an idea somewhere. And when I told Holy Rath, can I do something out there where my packaging starts talking to me or whatever. So my mantra was became like, make your packaging work hard while it sits on the shop shelf. So by that what I mean is that typically we do packaging designs which are basically a label. There will be a product shot or something like that. The brand logo would be there, and there will be nice colors and out there. And there is whatever bottle it's going in, this thing into package into that bottle is there. And imagine going to a shopping mall or a convenience store for that matter. What is the objective of packaging? Packaging is basically is fighting for attention in us. Amongst a lot of brands, right? So when you look at any brand, be it Kellogg's or be it Bimbar or anything, they're fighting a competition out there. And that competition starts from the time when a person decides to go to a convenience store or this thing. And that is where his decision is made. That is where he will feel that, okay, why should I, if I'm regularly using Colgate, and if Pepsodent packaging is more premium looking or more or different out there, chances are I will end up buying Pepsodent out there. So that is what the Pepsodent brand will try to fight Colgate on the battlefield, which is the convenience store. That's where the decision is made, right? But going to this thing, so that is the primary role of any packaging design. We will take a sidestep and say that what are the various types of packaging around us. So you typically you will see plastic bottles, pearl bed bottles out there, plastic molded containers, which have but basically which have the liquid from the product over there. So it can be a fruit pulp or a oil or a perfumes or deodorants or whatever, right? So this is plastic molded thing. Perfumes and deos often obviously come in cans and glass bottles. Then we have paper packaging, paper boxes, right? So typically if you see Palmol tea bags or whatever, they come in this thing, Kellogg's, Corn Flakes and all, they come in paper packaging. A lot many brands come into that. Then there are Ziploc pouches, right? Now, here again, what happens is that they come into different sizes where they are usually dispensable or they have Ziplocs so that it is reusable out there. So that is one of the things. So whenever you're thinking about a brand or a product, if you can think of a packaging which gives a little bit extra convenience to the consumer, it is more preferred, right? Imagine this Heinz coming into into a small bottle, a glass bottle, which earlier it used to come in any sauce or this thing. Carrying that glass bottle used to be like a problem where there is a spillage or this thing. There are kids who are not very friendly with glass, and there's a high chance that it can break and this thing. So safety wise also is this thing. So technology moved ahead and we got into pouches, which is plastic molded pouches out there. Now, after that, going forward, they also attached a cap to it so that you can dispense, you can take whatever amount you want to take and again seal it, and it became reusable and convenient. And it was easy to carry. So, tiffin boxes and picnics and everything, everywhere on a journey, if you have to carry this, it becomes very comfortable. Then there are glass bottles. Now, glass bottles again are ranging from typical, if you do vodka, whiskey, sauce, all these kinds of things, and there we have a paper label out there, right? So these are stickers. So if you see on the pouch, you are printing directly onto the pouch. Here again, you are printing directly onto the paper. Here it is. This is something on the fruity side. That is plastic. It's printed on plastic, and it is shrink wrap. So this is something called. The term is called shrink wrap, where the packaging gets fused to the bottle. And then you have Saffola, which is again a paper. Likewise, out here also, on wine bottles, on liquor bottles and this thing, there is always a paper label. You can also directly print on the glass. Okay, then there are also stickers available. There are 3D letters available, which we can share with you going forward. Typical category is Lays, right? These are foil-based things. So if you have taken a Lays packet, typically you will see that it is shiny, it has got a nice gloss to it. But when you open it, there is foil inside. And that foil is something called food-grade foil. So whenever you are handling food, right, there are some requisites which the government has built it well. The plastic, if you are even giving plastic out there or anything related to food, it has to be food grade. That is the FASAI's food authority of something of India has basically demarcated the as governing rules for this thing. So when you open the foil, it is food grade foil inside. On top of that, there is printing out here, which is glossy. And it also gives you a chance to play with this. So typically here, if you see, it is a matte printed thing where you don't see the foil on the outside. But if you leave certain areas, you can see the foil and take it, use it to your own advantage. Glass bottles, right? So Beluga, the vodka, has got a 3D fish on top of it. Even the words Beluga are 3D out there. And then the rest of the tin is designed on paper. And then pasted out there. Aquarose is again something which is like a shrink wrap thing out there. And more importantly, packaging also means trying to come up with a unique signature bottle, which will help your brand get established as a different brand identity. So typically, I don't need to tell you this, that vodka or whiskey, the packaging starts with the bottle. The bottle has to be different first as a signature thing. And the bottle has to make a mark with the customer. Only then it gets sold off. Or then, otherwise, if the bottle is a normal bottle, then your packaging has to be, the design has to be really, really different so that people can pick that bottle up. So basically what we looked at is plastic molded containers, paper boxes, stand-up Ziploc pouches, paper stickers on bottles, silver foil pouches, liquor brand bottles. Are we like clear till here? Everyone following?
Yes, sir.
Great. There's nothing great on that. This is just information on here. So now comes the printing part of it. So how many of you guys are aware about the printing processes? Oh, you are not.
No, sir.
So, typically, I think offset, everyone must be knowing, right? Or at least heard. So whatever you look at in terms of your paper, a newspaper or a magazine or anything, everything is printed on offset, a brochure or a catalog, anything. Anything is printed in offset. Offset typically means basically suppose if you have a photograph, you scan that photograph. And when you go into Photoshop, right, there is RGB and there is CMYK, right? Itna to malum hai sabko?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes.
So RGB is typically red, green, blue. CMYK is cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. K is for blank, right? What happens is that RGB can be used for digital. So whenever you are printing digital images, or say if you're doing for doing websites or they were doing your digital advertising, there you can use RGB. Outdoor hoardings, if you've seen, right, that printer is different. It's an RGB printer, and therefore there if you keep your file as RGB, it's accepted. But when it comes to offset printing, it has to be cyan, magenta, and black. Right. Now, have you guys followed till here?
Yes, sir.
So basically, kya hai ki whatever your artwork is, it gets scanned, then it gets separated. If you go on to Photoshop and if you check the cyan magenta values, you will see something like this. The things out here. This is the main image. When separated in cyan magenta and black, it becomes like this. So when printing, what happens is that the lighter colors get printed first, and then so yellow will typically get printed first, then magenta, then blue, and then black. Black is always printed last so that you can control within. These are cylinders on which the plates are, the offset plates are, basically you expose the plates and the image gets reversed out here. When you print on the paper, it gets a positive. So the typically a plate will have an offset image, negative image, then that gets into a positive image. This is something called rotogravure printing. You guys can, I'm not really going completely into detail out here. You guys can go onto the internet and check these processes. Rotogravure is typically this copper cylinder which you're seeing out here. It's again the same thing. Cyan, magenta, black, but then the image is transferred onto a cylinder. It is etched onto a cylinder. This is a copper cylinder. So like that, there will be four cylinders of each color, and the paper, the foil or the plastic, whatever the substrate is, will pass through this to get the image, right? So that is rotogravure. So typically all your lace packaging or your surface cell pouch or this thing, where it is basically sealed like this, is printed onto rotogravure. It's a typical rotogravure machine where it starts getting it. Now if you see this, we have four colors. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So there are 9 hubs out here. So typically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 hubs out here. So it means that you can print 8 colors. So what we mean by that is, suppose typically people who have no offset colors, offset inks are slightly dull, right? There are some colors like orange will not get printed properly out there. Offset colors might not have the vibrancy which a packaging design wants, right? Also, there is the inks, there is a problem of consistency of inks, right? Colors. So basically, there are various variables. I hope you guys are still fresh, and this is technical. I'm saying we'll come to the creative part of it, but if you understand this technical part of it, it will help you to think in terms of how to approach your packaging design. So coming back to that, basically a four color image tends to get a little bit dull, and over the period of time, let's suppose if I have printed one lot of packaging design and after that is over, I have printed a second lot, what happens is that there might be a color variation in the second lot. So typically if you see this green color, might not print like that, and therefore when it goes into the market, the customer might feel that ye shayad duplicate hai kyunki iska color barabar nahi hai, pehle jaisa tha waisa nahi hai, ye red print hoga. Offset image shayad theek tak print hoga because that is this thing, but again there is a certain variation. So what happens is that there is something called Pantone colors, right, which I am covering ahead out there, but just keep this, spark this thought of 8 cylinders when we have only 4 cylinders for CMYK. We come back to this. Another way of printing is basically screen printing. I'm sure you guys might be aware of screen printing, because if you guys have any workshop out there where if you have printed any visiting cards or whatever. So typically it is called silk screen printing. This is a screen out here. You expose your artwork to the screen. So what happens is it's got a photo sensitive material. So typically in a screen printing, the exposed area becomes transparent and it seals the other negative area. So what happens is that when you pass the ink, this is called a squeezy out here. So when you pass the ink through that, only the area which was exposed will get the color, the rest of the area will not. So typically if you see this, this is screen printing. Screen printing is also possible on bottles and this thing, on visiting cards and packaging designs. Digital printing, which I mentioned, right? Now, earlier what used to happen was that advertising and product advertising or launching a brand was a very, very, very tough process. Today, you see a lot many people are coming with a lot many brands out here, right? They are also experimenting with brands. That's purely because thanks to the technological advances in the printing industry. Thereby, through digital printing, you can actually get just one finished pouch like this. Typically, in printing, there used to be like you needed to have a huge order to make it economical, because either you need to print packaging in lakh. Ab lakh packaging print kar liya, uske baad mein agar market nahi hai aapke, to you will have basically the entire load of that, the lot of the packaging listing in your godown. And if your brand doesn't go become successful, then there is a high chance that you will suffer the losses of that. So therefore, this technology helps you to experiment. Like if you see, through digital printing, you can get one pouch like this, finished pouch. You can go to the market or the customer and do a sampling and say that, okay, here's my new brand. Try this and let me know what's your feedback. The other thing of packaging is that, and here you are not, you're saving the cost of cylinders, right? Typically, if you've seen here, the cylinder will cost you somewhere between, just the cylinder will cost you about 1 lakh or 2.5 lakh rupees. So basically, having a even if you do four color, there are four cylinders. So your starting budget is 10 lakh, investment is 10 lakh, right? That's a huge investment, and plus the paper substrate and all other things, the design and all that stuff. So here what happens is that you can basically, you cut down the cost of the cylinders out there because it's a digital printing machine, and you get singular packaging out there. If you see this ice cream, it's got flavors, right? Now imagine printing ye 10 lakh hua, ye 10 lakh 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18, right? So into 10 lakhs, if you do that, that is the amount of investment one has to do. Whereas if you get into digital printing, this might save you the cost considerably. There is also a cost out here. It turns out a little expensive, but not as expensive as your rotogravure printing in the first phase. Rotogravure, if you have if your numbers, if you have the numbers, like if you need like 10 lakh packaging design, orders, then rotogravure definitely will be cheaper. But you need to have those numbers also. So this is one where you can do a test market or of the brand. Metallic foil, right? Again, a very interesting thing whereby a lot of people have experimented with metallic foil. So I've given you samples where this is on paper. This is foil stamping out here. This is again paper, and using the advantage of paper, you are trying to experiment with printing. This is a bottle which is basically coated with metallic thing. Again, vodka bottles, if you see, they come with a lot many colors of metallic. Right, so basically, as a title reads, basically knowing what is CMYK combinations are to exactly know how specific designs would print or be produced when printed, right? So when you're working with CMYK, you need to be clear in terms of what is the percentage you are going and how this and offset, for example, typically needs there's a proofing method. So whatever you see on your screen, I'll just take a little break out here. So that doesn't boring to you guys. Okay, so till here, are you guys with me? Because I think it's okay. I don't know where. Hello.
Yes, sir.
आतापर्यंत कळलं का काय बोलतोय मी?
Yes, sir.
Interesting वाटत आहे का बोरिंग होत
आहे?
इंटरेस्टिंग आहे.
Technical things are boring, but if you know the technical things, then you might be able to do some great with that. Right? So hang on for a while, so I just get all of this boring part a little bit. I also know that it's boring, but it's very important. Right, so coming back to So CFI के जो आप रिप्रोड्यूस करते हो अपन, so basically क्या होता है कि all the screens, suppose you are working on say you're looking at the design on your mobile, maybe then you are working on the computer out here, obviously, and you have someone has a Dell का screen, someone has a Lenovo का screen, the other guys must have Apple का screens, then someone might have a even better resolution, there are some specialized monitors for this looking at designs which are in sync with the printed offset stuff paper. So problem here is digital, when you look at digital stuff, every screen will show you a different image, right? So your CMYK values which you see, values same hai, lekin the graphic representation on your screen is different and that varies. So therefore you might see that there is a certain, the design looks in a certain way on your screens, but when you print it, you might feel अरे यहाँ पे black ज़्यादा हो गया या dark हो गया फिर शायद white हो गया, all those problems come in. That's because your screens are not calibrated to be paper. So therefore, once you do the design, you need to get it printed, proofed. That's called something called proofing. Proofing. When you see, when you, that is the time when you see that okay, this artwork looks like that, then you again go back to your Photoshop to edit it, make it lighter or brighter or darker or whatever, and again you take a proof like that. If you, when you take a series of proofs, then you will be able to see that okay finally this is what I want, and then you get into the final printer, right? So that was CMYK. So this process happens before you approach the final offset printing or a rotogravure printing. This is, you need to have, be very sure about your printed proofs that this is how you want the design to be reproduced, right? Now there are a few things which you need to look into. There is something called Pantone shade cards, then knowing half tones. Orange typically in CMYK print, does not print well, right? Because it's a combination of magenta and yellow, and God knows why it doesn't print like that, but the inks don't support it, right? So therefore orange will never look vibrant out. So typically whenever we need to use Surf Excel orange in packaging, we used to use a Pantone shade card. Now what is a Pantone shade card? Is basically a series of inks which is, this looks like this. This is a Pantone shade card wherein there is a number given out here. If you see this Pantone yellow U, or if you see 102U, right? These are all direct inks. So these are customized and they are made with that, this thing, and this is a proof of the ink. So you know that this yellow will print like this only, right? So whenever you're going into, then if you go into say this Lay's packaging, this yellow will be a Pantone yellow, so that the consistency of that yellow stays. 20 लाख पैकेजिंग राउंड्स भी कर देंगे ना, तो भी अगर 1942 में छापा हुआ है ये पैकेजिंग, एंड इफ यू रिप्रोड्यूस इट इन टुडे इन 2020 और 2021 दिस टाइम, येलो विल प्रिंट एग्जैक्टली लाइक इट गॉट प्रिंटेड इन 1942. दैट्स द ब्यूटी ऑफ पैंटोन शेप कार्ड्स, राइट? सो दैट्स पैंटोन शेप कार्ड फॉर यू. So what Pantone shade cards do is basically they bring in vibrancy to your packaging designs. They use gradation in Pantone designs and use of metallic foils to your advantage. Typically, if you see whatever I was telling you in under the topic of knowing your half tones, this is same packet printing process where typically if you see cyan, magenta, yellow and black will look like this. The plates, the separation of the image. This is the final image, CMYK final. When you zoom into this now, you will see these dots. Now, if you see these dots, these are basically coming from a combination of these colors. So these dots get printed on top of each other to form the image. If you take any printed thing and if you look it through an eyeglass or a zoom into it, you will see, start seeing these dots. And that's basically that. These are the dots which appear on the plate of the offset plate. So when it prints on the paper, the dots get transferred out there. So typically if you are printing say green color, it will be 100 yellow and say 50 cyan. So there will be a 100 yellow ka dot, and then there will be a cyan, 50% cyan ka dot out there, which will create that after effect for you, photographic effect for you. This is how a CMYK shape card looks. This is called a process book. So what happens is that if you see here on the bottom, this thing, there is 100 cyan. This is 100 blue, this is cyan, and here it is 100 magenta. And all these things are a combination. So this is how you have to look at a, when you arrive at a color, or when you are, whenever you look at colors on your screen, this process book helps you to identify the distinct. So typically, if you check the values of this color, it will be 40 cyan and 60 magenta. Right? So that is how you will get this color. 40 cyan and 60 magenta, those are the values of this thing. Here it is yellow, and this. Now, if you see here, it is 0% yellow. The moment I add a little bit 20% yellow out here, the combination will be 60% magenta, 40% cyan, and 20% yellow out here. And that will give me whatever color. Again, here you can look up to on the YouTube videos, or you can look at this thing. Right. So you can look up at this thing and check this out. So here there is a representation of orange. How it is printed in CMYK and orange, how it is, what a pattern shape card would look like. Shape. So if you see, on the left hand side, the image is a little dull. On the right hand side, it is a little bit fresher and vibrant. How to bring vibrancy in your packaging design? So, wherever the colors, wherever you are using a patch, which is the, say, 70% of your design, if there is a patch, like I showed you the lace example, where yellow was your 70% thing. And of course, that yellow might be like 100 yellow and 25 magenta, right? So that yellow will keep on changing through series of print rounds. Therefore, if you use a Pantone shade card out there, then it will help you keep the color consistent. Proofing, I have told you about that. You can also replace dull shades with Pantone inks. Like suppose if it's expensive, but if I'm a client who wants to say that, okay, I want the colors more vibrant out there, I can easily replace those 4 CMYK shades. That will stay constant, but cyan, magenta, and yellow, I can use the Pantone inks and you can get a vibrant color out there. Also, what happens is that suppose if your packaging has got a photograph, like suppose so something like this is a photograph, right? So typically, the lace chips which you are seeing out here, this is a CMYK image. This is a CMYK image. This is a Pantone image, right? Hence, your packaging, again, this red is a Pantone red. So typically what will happen is that this particular job will be around, say, around 5 color or 6 color job, wherein you have the 4 color CMYK combination for this. This is a Pantone color, which is a separate color, and your red is a separate color. Right, so it becomes a 6 color job. Right, that's how you say that. Then you go. So this is basically, this is what I covered, like CMYK plus 1 or special colors. And depending on the design, you can choose to do it a 4 color plus 2 colors or 3 colors, so it becomes a 7 color or an 8 color job. And that's how, what I was saying out here, which is this machine out here, right? It basically means that you have 4 colors and plus 3 more colors or 4 more colors out here. It becomes a 8 color printing machine. I hope I am clear till this point, and you guys are seeing value in the presentation. Now come three interesting parts. So I think so till here, are you guys with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is something did you guys like have prior knowledge to it of this thing, or have I added some value to your life?
Yes, of course, sir.
Now comes the what I'm going to do is basically share a few examples with you that you come to know in terms of design or whatever my thought process also how I approach my work. Basically to give you a preview in terms of how to arrive at designs and this thing. We'll share some designs with you. You can give me your feedback, whether you like it, love it, or hate it. Okay, so I had a client, I still have him, thankfully. So these are two young boys who basically came to be a friend. They had lost their father, and their father, their business was a joint business among their uncles and everything. The brand was named after their father. Unfortunately, they lost their father at a very young age, and the boys were just like 20, 21 year olds, were like completely dumbfounded in terms of how to get more on with the business. And guess what? Their uncles suddenly gave them a legal clause saying that you cannot use the brand. Okay, that is the family business, and they said, they have come to the uncle and says that, boss, we are going to separate out and manage our own businesses now from year one. And one thing is that you will not be able to use the brand named after your father. Right? So these guys were like emotionally traumatized, saying that we have ek hi to dhanda hai, wo dhanda bhi ja raha hai, aur jo brand itne time se build kiya hai, wo brand bhi use kar. So typically these guys were into catering, and they are they have a decent business in the catering business, and a lot of Gujarati families are their clients, and they know them as a brand. Right? So what we did was basically look at the history of the brand and whatever this thing, unique selling point of the product. So that's the creative process, like to create a packaging for a brand of ice cream that has been in the market for the past 25 years and the brief document has to have a history of the brand. This is what we demand from the client. We talk to the client and try to get a history of the brand. The unique selling points of the product, consumer perceptions or insights of the brand or the product. So it's very important that I know as a designer or an art director or a creative director or whatever, that what is the brand? What is the category? Right. What are the insights of the category? When I say insights of the category, it will be like, how do people approach ice creams? What is their emotional attachment to the ice cream? When do they have ice creams? When do they do not have ice creams? Right. What is the unique selling point of the product? So all these questions need to be asked to the brand. And then I came to the point saying that what is the reason to change the packaging? That's where he started learning about whatever he wanted. So typically we said we will design tubs, which is ice creams. The task was also to redesign the brand logo, ice cream cups, candies, tubs, and that's the next example. So this was the logo, right? Now, this logo was designed by some designer. This was the style which existed say 25 years ago or 30 years ago, wherein Manoj was the name of the father. His dad, meaning Manoj's dad, must have thought, "Pehla beta hai uske naam pe, jisme bolte hain emotional, bol diya Manoj ke naam se this thing." वहां पे कोई डिजाइनर होगा जिसने बोला अच्छा आइसक्रीम हो अच्छा उसके ऊपर बर्फ डाल देते हैं, तो मनोज के ऊपर बर्फ डाल दिया और लोगो रेडी हो गया राइट। नाउ दिस लोगो हैड बीन देयर इन द इंडस्ट्री फॉर पास्ट 25 इयर्स। नाउ द किड्स वर टोल्ड दैट यू कैन नॉट यूज, सो ऑल द इक्विटी अटैच्ड टू द ब्रांड लोगो, द the identity of the brand was suddenly taken out of their hands and said that boss you cannot use that logo. So kya hota hai ki jab it's like you are going into a party out there, imagine you are invited to a party and you are told that you have to wear a mask or you have to wear a paper bag on your head. So irrespective of whatever, however famous you are, you don't have an identity, right? Imagine Ranbir Kapoor coming to your party wearing a paper bag on his head, right? There is nothing, right? So there is no face. That's the dilemma these guys are facing now. So what did we do, right? Abhi, my challenge was that when you say Manoj or anyone in your with that kind of a name, you attach emotions which are linked to that experience of that person. So agar Manoj mere liye villain hua hai, agar mere life mein agar koi Manoj hai aur wo agar villain hai, to sare emotions of villainy will get attached to the brand, right? Agar acha banda hai to theek hai, acha banda hai to acha hai, but agar villain hai to nafra hai. So we said that okay, then the logo has to stop looking like a name and start looking like a brand. So this is all what we designed. Okay. Any reactions? So here the challenge was basically to make it not look like a brand, a name, and can I add some values to it in terms of an ice cream? So what is an ice cream? Ice cream is all about celebration, a nice moment, a positive moment, a day when I am happy, all those emotions, right? So that's, we try to incorporate all those things into a logo out there. And then there was a simple thing of crafting ice creams for generations. And the basic thought, so here again remember that there was a legal angle to it, that you cannot use Manoj ice creams, right? He said, okay, we'll do it, we'll rename it as Manoj's ice cream. So we have added that apostrophe S out there. And that's how we got out of that legal tangle and said that, okay, now it is not Manoj, it is Manoj ice cream. So we basically ended up giving him his father's name, which he rightfully wanted out there. And we got him out of a legal tangle. So as art directors, as designers or creative directors or whatever, your job is also to think strategically for a brand, right? So it's not just about doing a design, it's about thinking differently for the task at hand. And here the task was that the client was arriving saying that I want to use Manoj, lekin aap legally atak jaoge agar ye Manoj ko use karte hain to, but meko to Manoj hi chahiye. So if you want Manoj, then okay, let me think about it, and that's how we arrive at this thing, right? So this is a small story around that brand. The client was happy for it, he loved it, he thought, loved the thought that he had a nice smile to it, his brand, his father's name was incorporated to it, and we didn't lose essence. So what happened was, in the market, they said that okay, we have relaunched the brand, so the equity stayed with them. And they could launch the brand, because otherwise, if the legal angle, according to the legal angle, they would have to change the ice cream to something else, the brand, which could have been like Happy. Say, if I say Happy Ice Creams, then Happy Ice Creams is a different brand. People don't know, and all the legacy for the past 25 years gets washed out. Right. So that is the task at hand, and that's how we solved this one. This was the packaging design for that. Right, we saw a face, a happy face out there. So we said, okay, let's start. And the challenge is also to make the packaging look different. राइट क्योंकि नॉर्मल आइसक्रीम पैकेजिंग में सब जगह आइसक्रीम स्कूप होता है व्हिच इज काइंड ऑफ देयर तो लुक कर रहे हो हाउ कैन वी डू समथिंग डिफरेंट दैट्स हाउ वी अप्रोच इट देन वी स्टार्टेड अटैचिंग इट टू द हैप्पीनेस कोशेंट ऑफ द ब्रांड सो यू विल typically have an ice cream when you have gone to a beach or for surfing or whatever or as a kid you are like on the what do you call it cloud nine or whatever right so we are just trying to see how can you associate your ice cream out there and incorporate that ice cream scoop into the design right a typical juggler maybe there is one opportunity where we thought that okay look into the future or this so we are trying to play around with the thing and try to see if you can make it more interesting. On a sunny day, okay, this was the, they are also into catering, right? Are you guys with me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Finding it interesting?
Yes, sir.
Right, so then, the next task was catering. So catering, they are into catering. So typically, if you go into a wedding, you have a ice cream box of 1 kg, 2 kg, 5 kg box out there, from which they take the scoops and they give it to you, right? So they are not giving you branded ice creams out there. But then, here the target audience was the caterers. So they wanted the caterers to know that they have relaunched the brand, right? So what we did was basically also told them that they should start coming into retail space. Retail space is basically it to start being available as a start an ice cream parlor or say available in the shops. So again here what we started doing was trying to see the party moment, the happy moment. So this was a typical wedding ke liye jo party packs aate hain wo hai. This is suppose if you are just having a party out there, so that is running out here. Right? मोमेंट इन योर लाइफ पीछे आइसक्रीम का सूप था राइट बट यस कैन यू ऐड अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ फन एलिमेंट टू इट दैट वाज द ऑब्जेक्टिव देयर आर वेरियस डिजाइन्स टू इट दिस वाज पार्टी पैक राइट सो फ्रेंड्स कमिंग टुगेदर एंड दिस थिंग दिस वाज So the mix pack where you had two ice creams in one pack, which was vanilla and strawberry. It was again a party pack. Diwali, taking the festival seasons of India. Okay. This is for candies. You just get what I have. Okay, so this is where you start paying a little bit more attention because we are going to get into an assignment of more out here from here on. What you guys need to do is that you guys have to pick and choose your teammates, favorite friend, person I don't like, or person I like can be in or out of the group, whatever the way you guys think it's better to would be better to express your designs or whatever. So we'll divide you into groups. Then as a group you start picking up a product or a brand and we start designing. So, what you need to do is that when you are picking up a brand, you need to understand what is the product category out there which you are choosing. research about the existing competition for the brand's packaging. So whatever product or category you choose or brand you choose, you have to do a little bit of research on the existing competition in terms of what is the advertising, what is the brand, what is the brand positioning out there. Research about the product benefit. So these three things you have to do on that. The creative process is read the brief carefully, ask more questions to the brief to get more clarity. Now, you guys need to create your own brief out here. Like, once you choose the product, you need to set a goal for the brand as to what is the expected result you want from the market when the packaging gets launched into the market. That is one thing which you need to do. Ask questions to the brief to get more clarity. Identify your TG, target audience. Is it a male, female, or both? Age group. Socio-economic background of the TG. Like, when I say socio-economic, is he, like, if I have to look at mobiles, is he a Samsung user? Is he a Apple user? Is he a Vivo user? So it's basically depending on a person's ability to spend, or even there might be people who might not afford, but they still own an Apple iPhone because the mindset is that, or the aspiration is that, and they will compromise their other expenses to arrive at this expense. That is also a TG. So not necessarily that when I say socio-economic, it is about their spending capacity or their income. It is about their aspiration also, or a mind frame to own a brand. User insights you have to look at. When I say user insights, it is about how does the user behave, right? In a person's shirt or a t-shirt gets dirty or stained, how does the user react to it? Does he go and immediately pour some water and try to wash off the stain? That's first instinct. Or do we say that, okay, ye to stain ja sakta hai, no problem. That is instinct. Product insights are basically how does the product behave, or what is the unique selling point of the product, or is there any specific way the target audience approaches a product? What is the environment of the brand? Where is it available? Is it available on a paan ka dukaan? Is it available on a convenience store? Is it available on online? The product usage, how is the product being used? And write down anything and everything about the product. Right? So these are the slides which basically you need to, I might mail it to you also. But then this is what you need to keep in your mind when you are working on the product. So this is how, see, this is, these are basically what are the, these are the, this is the way we follow the process in advertising. We might write it down, we might not make a presentation out there, but at some subconscious level, we think about all these things and then approach your design. Now, typically, if you've seen, what happens is that there's a hard-working label out there, which is typically, and that also is about the product. So a product's necessity might be that we establish the brand logo and have a product benefit out there depicted onto it, or it can be a simple packaging design, but yes, it has to be an attractive packaging. That's one way of doing it. The other way of doing it is that can we make the packaging work a little more harder? Now I will just... That way, if you can, if there is an opportunity to think about an idea into packaging design, it is good. That's how you might immediately stand out from your competition. So that's what we did in Manoj's things, right? We put an idea to it, right? And the packaging hence started looking different. So here are a few samples which I have personally done throughout my career, which I'd like to show you, because I always believe that if I'm giving you GAN, then I should also be the one who is showing you the proof of performance that I have done something. Look at that GAN, you know. So this was a slimming tablet, which we got. A typical slimming tablet sold off the counter at a chemist called Slimona. This was like a small, like my double layer, this size. Altoids ka case hota hai. So this was the packaging idea for that, right? So this was a plastic container which looked like a weighing scale. The font was designed as a from fat to thin. This is how it looked. Actually, by the way, Photoshop may create here, right? Or people who are ignoring Photoshop skills or saying that acha wo to look kar lenge karke. You are in third year right now. I don't know if you have a fourth year. Maybe you are in the final year. If you are in the final year and you want to get into an advertising agency, the first thing you need to do is basically know about execution also, which we can cover at some point of time. But just for your information, this is designed in Photoshop, finished in Photoshop for client presentation. This is how the tablets will stick out, come out of it. Right? This is for a hand blender. Now, hand blender, this I'm talking about at a time when, in 2003-2004, when India was going through a economic lifestyle change, wherein people from the lower socio-economic segment were also getting introduced to hand blender. That's when Chinese revolution started coming in, right? So typically what happened was that things from made in China were becoming cheaper and cheaper, and therefore technology was being made affordable to the lowest strata of the society. So here, this brand, basically this brand was available at mini metros, like tier 2 cities, where if you take Ahmedabad or Bhuj or Nasik or this thing, where the income group of the capacity of the people is slightly lower, but the aspiration to own the technology was always there. So the technology was new to them, and we thought that, okay, if we have to create a hand blender, then can we add a little bit different idea to it so that it solves a problem? Now, typically what happens is that you design a packaging, it is there on the shelf of the shop, you go to the shop, tell the shop people that, okay, get me that, show me that. The shop people goes, agar 10 customer pada hai, samne khada hai, to 10 minute ke baad mein aapka number aayega, aur tabhi wo jaake wahan se leke aake aapko dikhayega, right? So we said that, okay, that kind of problem where people will try to open, because it's new technology na, to khole dekhe, Indian jam, right? We will open it, we will see it, to usme wo gir jayega niche, toot jayega, jo bhi hai, phir bolega re yaar, पैसा नहीं दूंगा, ये नहीं देगा, पैकेजिंग खराब हो जाएगा, होल लॉट ऑफ इश्यूज कैन बी देयर. सो कैन यू एज अ डिजाइनर कट दिस प्रोसेस वाज द थॉट. सो दिस वाज द ब्लेंडर व्हिच वी लॉन्च्ड. अच्छा, व्हाइल डूइंग सो वी वांटेड टू कीप द डिजाइन लुकिंग वेरी प्रीमियम, राइट? Right, so what it did was basically this same packaging could be used as a dangler. Like iska dabba bana ke main agar hang kar do shop mein upar, to kya hoga? Public ko process pata chal jayega ki ye jo auzar hai ye kya karta hai, ye pata chal jayega, right? So it saves the shopkeeper the hassle of going back, taking this thing and explain it to the customer that ये exactly करता क्या है. खूब सारे, अभी ये ऑर्पैट का ही एक आयन था स्त्री, स्त्री में क्या करेंगे, क्या करेंगे कुछ नहीं करेंगे इसको, हम लोग बस अच्छा दिखा देते हैं पैकेजिंग वाइज, इट हैज टू लुक टेम्पटिंग वाज द थॉट। इसमें भी क्या है कि यू डोंट नीड टू ओपन द बॉक्स एंड शो टेक आउट द आयरन राइट, बाहर से देख ले जो भी डब्बा देखना है अंदर कैसा है इसकी, सब एंगल से देख दिखा दीजिए राइट, एंड दैट बिकेम एन इंटरेस्टिंग डिजाइन आउट देयर इवन टिल देट। The best of the brands don't have this kind of packaging. So though Orpat, say if Orpat irons was available at say 250 rupees or whatever that cost might be, the costliest iron, which is a Morphy Richards brand, which might be available for 2000 rupees or something like that, was still not looking as premium as this. So our job is to make the brand look more premium. Tara refined oil. Dara Refined Oil came up with a proposition saying that I am good for your heart. Right? Saffola is also talking about good for your heart. Dara is also talking about good for your heart. How do you do that? Now this is here again, it is just not just packaging, it also comes by as product design. Right? You as art directors, as this thing, you can also experiment with your product design. So if you see this, I applied a little bit of my product design skill sets, which is typically it looks like a heart. So the instant communication to the customer is that I am talking about your heart. I am an oil and I am talking about your heart. So good for your heart comes this thing. It's a happy heart, right? It's a fresh, nice, green heart out there. There is a tilt out here, right? So if I am having a 5 kg can, I don't need to lift it up and pour it. I can just slide it down and it starts pouring. That was one of the thoughts which we applied to it. Then if you see, as it goes to the handle, na, it tapers, right? Ye thickness, na, difference hai. So what happens is basically ease of lifting. So grip wise, if you can do that, that was the thought behind that. Abhi ye, this is not readily available, right? This is some packaging which we basically thought about that we will do something. So the process for this thing is that you do this, then you create a die out of it, get a die made, and then you create this packaging, right? But it is a different packaging design, so you will stand out in the market. So objective was that when you are on the convenience store shelf, shop shelf, your packaging looks different. And there is a pick-me-up value. There is some news value to it. As an art director, I always had this aspiration that I want to work on a liquor brand. And God has been very graceful, and I thank Him for that, that He granted me this wish also. So, this brand we created from the scratch for this packaging. So, this was basically imported, Vodka was imported from Poland. Right, it was bottled in Poland also. So what we did was basically we did some research where we stumbled upon this story that the first tribe which settled down in Poland, the decision they took was after they saw an eagle on top of in the sky. So the tribe leader looked up, he saw eagles hovering around that land. So they had that influence that, okay, there is food available out there, right? This is when Poland, it's like when civilization was getting established in this thing, that is the story out there, which is, so yahan pe animals hai, toh apne ko khana milega, was the basic thought behind that, and that's how Poland came to be. So, and here was a vodka which was born in Poland and bottled in Poland. So therefore, that was one of the insights which we took to that as a brand story. And this is how the first design was conceptualized. Now again, this is a very, what we call, comprehensive design. So the first design which is being presented to the client, right? Now the name was Trip, So trip is again, this is like typically when you go to discotheques and this thing, I am tripping on it, was the lingo, right? Typically they are going headbanging and this thing and the trance of tripping and this thing. So that's what the name trip. Okay. So what? So then we designed this. Now I'm just doing something. The clients loved it, loved the design. This was the second stage for it, wherein we created a acrylic mold for it. And you guys are able to see us? Hello?
Yes.
Okay. Right. So this is a typical acrylic mold. If you see this, this has got ridges out here, right? Thick ridges out here. And so this is basically a graphic representation of how the bottle will look. Now, I'm not a product designer, right? I've not studied the product design part of it, but I have the, what do you call it? The kira. So I didn't know how to get the literature of this thing. Design to kar diya, lekin bottle mein ek liter vodka aayega. I don't know how to measure that in terms of volume and this thing and all that. So what we did was then I approached a AutoCAD designer. In AutoCAD, it basically gives you the literature and everything. So that person basically helped me out with the engineering drawing of the bottle. And he said that, okay, the volume of this thing is 1 liter. Now I didn't trust him. What is the guarantee? Because I have to finally be answerable to my client, right? Suppose I had given the engineering drawing and tomorrow when they finally start bottling it, they experience that they are only 75 ml jar, 750 ml jar. Then it will be a problem, right? So what I did was the next step was got it 3D printed. Now, unfortunately, I don't have the 3D printed bottle with me. 3D printed bottle is basically, you guys must be aware about 3D printing. 3D printing is where you can get an actual bottle made, hollow bottle, right? So we did that. We poured 1 liter bottle into it, this thing, liquid into it, to check it. And once I confirmed that, this thing, then I presented the engineering drawing to the client, right? Now, after that, the second phase was that to get this thing from the client. To the guys who will actually make it. So this was the first sample of the bottle, right? So I encountered a problem out here whereby typically when you make a die, the die opens like this. So it's a die which opens like this, right? The bottle is in between, so you pour the silica, whatever the glass thing is, silica gel, and it opens, it has to open like this. So it will open like that. So ye mold open nahi ho raha. Right, that was because the twists and turns out here were preventing it, the mold from opening. And therefore, we got a cut out here, which is a problem. The design was not intended to have a cut, but then the mold was created, not opening up, therefore they had to do this. To which I communicated, and by the way, this was all being done in China. Right, so we communicated back to them saying that we don't want this cut. So they suggested that, okay, then we have to reduce the depth of these ridges. Now this is all product development, right? Packaging product development. So these ridges were created, were reduced. So again, then we said that to the guys, the factory who was making the bottles, that now you present as a engineering drawing, which will basically keep the concept intact and yet get the objective of getting the mold out. That was the thing. Then if you see this, we have designed an emblem, an eagle out here, and it says imported from the country where vodka was born. That was basically the advertising proposition for them. This is the final bottle, which was finally done in China, right? Now if you see this, these are all 3D letters. we have the eagle was created like a medallion. I don't know if I'm going to that. So the eagle again will come as a mold out here. So it will be a coin, a metallic coin, which will be pasted on top of it. Right? The thing is that it will basically then be used for advertising. So imagine a kiosk on the airport which has this bottle. The bottle will be rotating like this. So it appears like a screw. It is like going round and round continuously like this. And your eagle will be imagine on a black background. A gold eagle, a gold, what you call it? Plated, a gold plated or a copper plated eagle out there, right? So make it look more premium. Coming back to, I think someone who said that fine art, ke jana tha, fir baad mein applied art mein aa gaye, right? So keep your drawing skills intact, right? They came handy to me while I was, the reason why I'm telling you is that I reached an illustrator to get the eagle like the way I wanted out there, but somehow he was not able to visualize, and he presented to me some 10-15 iterations and I was not really happy with that thing. So finally I took the drawing board, I went to the drawing board and I designed it myself, I drew it myself. And then I got in a friend who was a sculptor to get this sculpted out like the way I wanted. Right? So keep your drawing skills at your hand so that they are always handy. Then, koi bhi kaam nahi kar sakta hai, toh aapko kaam karna aana chahiye, kaam karna aana chahiye. And that applies to, like I keep telling my people who join my agency also, that you have to be a proficient in editing. So Photoshop, Premiere Pro, whatever software are available, right? You have to have knowledge about everything. And you have to attempt to master those skill sets because you never know when you will need these skill sets. Because when the world fails you, for any person to avoid getting into your own, giving you the result, I'd say I'm very possibly, if you don't know the software, or if you don't know, if you've not been through that road, na, they'll say, ah, ye toh hota possible nahi hai. You need to be able to know it so that you can challenge and get things the way you want them to be. This was for Parle Ji. We did a small thing of adding those milk things and making that Parle Ji branding. Packaging design for Musk Bikes. Now here, Musk Chips and this. Here the challenge was, as an art director, the challenge was to come up with these colors, these very colors. Because finally, CMYK mein char color hi hai, par combination to utna hi. Green, yellow, blue mein yellow dalo to green banega. Red mein yellow dalo to orange banega. Yellow mein green color, haan. All those combinations. There are only certain, so many available combinations out there. Now imagine 12 packaging designs which look different, and they have to be vibrant. Staying vibrant is the key to this thing, right? So therefore, we had a good task to basically get these things out. To energy drink. So the logo for it. There are client presentations. This was a bottle shrink wrap. Now here, what we thought was that can we have a story onto a bottle? So every bottle had a story of a superhero. Okay. So that was the campaign kind of thing visualized for that. Two packaging. This was some other approach for the shoe. This was for a energy drink again, wrong. Vitamin water, a bottle that looked like a battery cell, colors, different flavors out there in vitamin water. This is again another different looking pack. Now, see, some of these packagings might work, some of them might not, but at least there is an attempt to think differently. So here we thought that Vita Plus, so can we utilize the thought of a plus out there? So from the top, you would look, if you keep the packaging stack, you might look like this. From the sides, it will look like this. From the front, and the sides will look like this. So this will like fit into this. Now again, so an attempt to create some stunning packaging around this thing, and basically stretch your creative skill sets and thought process to achieve a different design. So I think I've done. So now feedback. अच्छा लगा बुरा लगा बोर हुआ शायद अच्छा नहीं
ना इट वाज ग्रेट सर
सो व्हाट डू गाइस थिंक अबाउट इट हाउ डू वांट टू सो सी माय अटेम्प्ट वाज बेसिकली टू I've always seen that packaging was something which was always a subject which was not given that much importance. Anyone wants to do advertising, everyone wants to think of an idea, everyone wants to think of a television commercial or a print ad or a magazine ad or anything. But what I realized through my career is that anything what you are doing in a brand, in the life of a brand, or in advertising, or in your own life, you start approaching it with an idea or with a thought, then you will be able to do some work which is different than the regular work. It applies to packaging design, it applies to exhibition display, it applies to your magazine ads or a print ad or a television commercial or whatever. So whatever you do or you're doing in this scope of design or advertising, if you apply idea to it, your life will be different and interesting, and you'll enjoy working.